Yes, the clocks are ticking, my friends. History has got a strict timetable. If we're not careful, we might be remembered as the country where everybody arrived too late. Come to school! No, before they kill you all, come to school!
Oh, before I forget, do you have the time? It seems like the watch is running a bit slow. So, how did you get involved with them and the competition?
I wanted to do it.
Really?
Yeah. Mr. M came to me weeks after the initial debate with Tammy. He said, what a contest. But at the same time, what a waste. Yes, you heard me correctly, a waste. They shouldn't be fighting each other, they should be fighting together.
Really?
Yeah. He said, if the sight of them as opponents is so exciting, imagine what it would be like if they were allies.
I bet you weren't after that. Ready to pounce on the challenge?
No, I was excited then. But when he said, I've seen too much of this, Isabel. Wasted people. Wasted chances. It's become a phobia with me. The thought that you and Tommy would become another victims of this country's lunacy was almost too much for me. Then I was convinced.
Lunacy, huh? Well, it's a lunacy that hasn't changed much. Did your team win at least?
No, we didn't compete.
So do you think we can at least talk about it? Help me to understand. Because to be absolutely honest with you, Tommy, I don't think I do.
Don't you know what is going on?
The dreaded unrest has finally reached us as well.
We don't call it that. Our word for it is Isiqualo, the beginning. We start boycotting classes tomorrow.
Does Mr. M know about that?
I think he does now.
Wasn't he at the meeting?
The meeting was organized by the comrades. He wasn't welcome.
How long do you think it's gonna last?
We'll go back to school once the authorities scrap Bantu education and recognize and negotiate with the student committees. That was the resolution last night.
But when the boycott and, you know, everything is over, could we carry on then, if there is still time?
I hadn't thought about that.
So think about it, please.
It's hard to say, Isabel. But, yeah, maybe we could. I'm not sure.
Not much enthusiasm there, Mr. Bikwana. You're right. Why worry about stupid competition? It's probably gonna be too late anyway. So that's it then. Let's just say that we gave ourselves a crash course in English literature. Could have done a lot worse with our spare time, could we? I enjoyed myself. I read a lot of beautiful poetry, which I might never get around to. But it doesn't mean the end of everything, though, does it? I mean, we can still see each other as friends.
When?
You know, I mean, like, anytime. Next week! I'm not talking about the competition. I accept that it's dead. I think it's a pity, but so what? I'm just talking about you and me, just as friends. Oh. So our friendship was an old-fashioned idea, after all. Well, don't waste your time here. You better get going and look after whatever it is that's beginning. And good luck. Stupid somewhere, and it's probably me, but it just doesn't make sense. I know it does for you, and I'm sure it's just my wide selfishness and ignorance that's stopping me from understanding, but it still doesn't make sense. Why can't we carry on seeing each other as friends? What's wrong with our friendship?
You're putting words in my mouth, Isabel. I didn't say there was anything wrong with it, but others will not see it the way we do.
Who? Your comrades?
Yes.
And they're gonna decide whether we can or can't.
I was right! You don't understand what's going on!
And you're certainly not helping me to!